The show's coverage of the minor leagues continues as we make a stop in the 10-team AAA West. Tonight, we've got a good matchup in store between the Sugarland Skeeters and the Salt Lake Bees. It's baseball, it's the show, and it comes your way next. And now here is Ross Adolph. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. And he finds a way to catch the zone here. It's 1-2. And he goes down and gets this fastball and takes it high in the air to deep straightaway center. There to take it is Trout, and that's out number one. So one down, no one aboard. And that brings in the left-handed hitting outfielder, Michael Brantley. And it's 1-2.
I got to count 1-2.
Really deceptive changeup right there. It died right before the plate, and he was left reaching for air.
1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2. Hit back up the middle. Barreto brings it in. And there's out number two. So next to hit is Ronnie Dawson. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Hit to short. Barreto fields cleanly. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Striding in is Dexter Fowler. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. Coming down in buckets, cats and dogs, insert metaphor here, and the forecast is not showing any signs of relief.
You know, one of the big issues is player safety, and right now this field is getting sloppy wet, Matt, and I don't know how much more rain this field can take.
And Fowler swings and misses as he's retired for round number one. 1-2 is taken for ball two. Bases are empty, one man out. And it's fouled away. Hangs on him a bit that time as it's belted out toward deep center field. And this one is gone, a home run. At the plate now, Mike Trout. Very high, 2-1. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. And the slider gets him swinging, two gone. So two out, nobody on. And the next hitter will be the right-handed bat of Anthony Rendon. A 2-2 count. Here's the pitch. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this
got him looking, and that'll do it. The inning is over. All set for the start of the inning, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Taylor Jones. Even count, two balls and two strikes.
He was absolutely all over that fastball. Have to find a way to keep that fair.
Three balls, two strikes.
Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now. Grounded slowly to the left side. Barreto's got it. On the first, and there's one gone here to start the second. Next to dig in, number 13. This will be his first trip to the plate in this one. 2-2. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. And it's gone. plate now, Jordan Brewer. Swing and a little blooper to center. Trout coming on. He can't get to it. This one's down. Into the box now, Freudis Nova. And he misses with that one for ball four. So that'll put runners on first and second now with one away.
The second baseman, Yovar Garcia.
Hey, time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
The 2-1. Two balls and two strikes now. And he tries to get him to reach for it, but it stays outside. 3-2.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
Popped him up. Rendon in foul ground. Into the stands. He got it. So here is Garrett Stubbs. Two's all over the place. Two on, two out, and, of course, here in inning number two. Here's the 1-1. Ripped down the line, but a foul ball, 1-2 now. One and two, here it is. And he got him. Minimizing the damage at just a run, the inning is over. Last half of the second set to go, and here comes the first baseman, Matt Theis. Swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out. And now, Scott Scheffler. And he fouls this one off. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. Right fielder giving chase. He gets there, and that's the second out. And next up will be Franklin Barreto. Trying to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. 1-1. Misses for the second ball.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Count even at 2-2. Here's a hard hit ball that'll be caught out there at short. Pretty much right in the glove that time, and the inning is over. And stepping in, Ross Adolph, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Swing and a miss as he starts the third, the same way he ended the second, with a punch out, one away.
The left fielder.
So bases are empty with one out now. And Michael Brantley settles in to hit at the plate. Couldn't lay off that time. It's 1-2. And he popped him up. Barreto moving to his left. He hauls it in without any trouble. And there are two away.
Now
next, it'll be Ronnie Dawson grounded out in his last at bat. The 1-1. Popped him up. And he'll get under it to put it away in foul territory, and that ends the inning. Bottom of the third now, and set to go is the second baseman, Mitch May. The 1-1.
Ball two.
You do not want to walk the eight-hole hitter. It just opens up so many options. Do we bunt them over to second with the nine-hole hitter? Do we try and play for that big rally with the top of the order coming up? This is a huge pitch. You can't allow this guy to walk.
Batting none.
So next to bat will be Chad Wallach. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. The 1-1 home. Waves and misses for strike
ball,
number two. Still a ball and two strikes. Here he comes again, 1-2. And this is swung on and missed. Five quick strikeouts now, and that's your first out of the inning.
The right
here's Dexter Fowler
Dexter.
Now.
Fowler.
There's ball a fastball well off the plate for a ball. Joe Adell waits on deck. And he lays off here. Four. Nice job. It's ball four. First and second now with one away.
No left fielder.
A couple of runners on base with one down. And sizing up the situation to bat will be Joe Adell. On that fastball's too much for him there. 1-2. And it's two balls and two strikes now.
When a pitcher puts you in the proverbial rocking chair like he's doing right now, you have to take a deep breath. You can't start trying to guess along with him. Trust your fundamentals and stay on that fastball.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Joe Adell becomes out number two this inning. Ready with the 1-2. Weak grounder down the line at third. And he'll get in there safely. In now, Anthony Rendon nipped the corner, 2-2. Fouled off. Two and two, here it is.
For the guy in the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Oh, that hit him. Let's hope he's okay. Fortunately, he's able to stick with it and get the out at first, and that'll put an end to the inning. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Taylor Jones. He's 0-for-1 thus far. The 2-2. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out. Next, here is number 13. Off to a fine start in this one after launching a homer his first time up.
Well, Matty, we know he's got the timing on the fastball locked in. That's what he got a hold of on that home run in the previous at bat. You do not come off the heater. Have to be leery of the off speed, but stay on the fastball. He's got to throw it again.
Hit to first, fielded cleanly. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Stepping up is Matt Theis. He's set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning. There's ball two as the slider dips below the zone.
Hasn't seen a heater yet in this at bat. One might be coming right here.
And he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. And that is off the wall. He'll get it into second. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
The batter, number 44, designated hitter, Scott.
So now to the plate, Scott Schebler. No offer on that one, and Verlander's run at full now, 3-2. Fouled away. Theis leads off second with nobody out. Lifted down the line and left. Here comes Brantley. He gets there and makes the play for the first out. And the runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base. Now at the plate, here is Franklin Barreto. Hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat.
Yeah, Matty, it's always a little frustrating when you square one up. You hit a solid line drive like he did, and all you have to show for it is a jog back to the dugout. That can get in your head for a little while.
So he racks up the swinging strikeout on the breaking ball. Franklin Barreto becomes out number two this inning. The count now at 2-1. 2-1, here it is.
Ball back outside.
well out in front of the breaking ball there for a strike.
You know he wants to end this inning right here on 3-2, but I don't think we'll see him lay one in on the next pitch there with the base open to work with.
Reined in. Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. New inning set to get underway, and stepping up as the shortstop, Freudis Nova. Change up just off the black, and it's 2-1. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
And a good eye here as he takes ball four, and it's a base on balls to lead off the fifth inning.
The batter number three.
Next to hit is Robo Garcia. He flew out in his last AB. The 1-1 home. Misses ball two.
Boy, not exactly what you'd like as a pitcher. One of the keys is to minimize your pitches, attack the strike zone early, a lot of deep counts, and working himself into a lot of trouble.
Fidel is right there as he puts it away. No problem for the first down. Now next up, Garrett Stubbs. He went down on strikes in his last at bat.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. And they'll have runners at the corners following the one-out single. Into the box, Ross Adolph. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
Everyone in the ballpark knows what the pitcher's intentions are in this situation. Great job at the plate to lay off a tough pitch in a good spot.
The count now is 2-2. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. The 2-2 is laid off, and the count runs full.
I don't think he can afford another base runner here, so whatever pitch he feels best about, whichever one he feels most comfortable with.
Meanwhile, this ball gets down. It's a base hit. Notch one in the score column as a runner from third crosses the plate. It's now a 2-1 ball game. At the plate now, Michael Brantley. 3-1.
You fight so hard to get into these type of counts. You can't let this pitch get away from you. You have to keyhole something middle of the plate.
Hit softly down the line at first. But this will wind up foul as he runs the count full now. 3-2 pitch. Hits the top of the zone. He struck him out looking. Stepping in next, Ronnie Dawson. And we'll see what he can do here with a pair of runners on base and two gone here in the fifth. The set and the 2-1. Now a swing, and he gets him to pop it up. Nay is there to make the catch, and the side is retired. Digging in will be Chad Waller, struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
The batter, the right fielder, Dexter
Fowler. Stepping in now, Dexter Fowler. And he misses Dexter there for ball four. So runners are at first and second now with nobody out.
The left fielder, number seven.
So stepping in is Joe Adell, trying here to plate the tying run from second. Skied into straightaway right. Adolph is there, and he makes the catch for the out. The relay, and he is in there. Here's the center fielder, Mike Trout. Potential tying run for him at third base.
Mike Trout.
The 2-2 doesn't get the zone. Count full now.
Definitely in a tough situation facing the three hitter. You can work around him and maybe walk him to load the bases, but that just sets up the cleanup guy with the bases loaded.
He loses him on ball four.
The third baseman, number six.
Hits are now even at four apiece.
Anthony Red, no.
And it's fouled away. The next 3-2. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Catch made in center. Here comes the runner from third. Now it's cut off. A throw to the plate. And this will get into the books as a sack fly and an RBI, and we are tied at 2. Now to the plate, Matt Seitz. A hit in 2 at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Ready with the 1-1.
He's already walked 2 in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
The 2-1 pitch. Well outside with the curveball for a ball. And he continues to labor here, coming up on 100 pitches in just the 5th inning.
Boy, D-Row, this is a spot right now. If you're an offense, you start licking your chop. Pitch count starting to get up.
And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Junior Guerra takes over to start the 6th inning on the mound.
Number 41, Junior.
So now to the plate, Taylor Jones. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
Beautifully thrown splitter right there. High 80s down to the zone. Looks like a fastball coming in, then boom, the bottom falls out of it. Terrific pitch.
So he notched the backwards K on that one. Taylor Jones goes down to become the first out in the 6th inning. Here it comes on 1-1. Hit out towards second. Scooped up. On to first, and there were 2 down. To the plate now is the designated hitter, Jordan Brewer. He grounded out last time up. Here's the 1-1. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Peter Solomon enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the 6th.
Now pitching for Sugarland, number 71. Peter.
Bottom of the 6th inning now, and striding forward the designated hitter, Scott Schebler. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Looked like he tried to pull it there, but he swings right through the fastball. He stays alive, still 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. And he takes strike 3 called on the fastball. 1 gone. Digging in next, Franklin Barreto. He was sat down on strikes in his last at bat. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going.
Looked like he was cheating a heater right there. A little bit too far out in front. Got to find a way to keep his hands back.
Even count, 2 balls and 2 strikes. Ground ball right side. He'll get to this one deep in the hole.
He's out.
Flip from short right gets him, and there are 2 away. Stepping in once again is Mitch Ney. He bounced out last time up. Still even at 2-2. And now a pitch on the way. And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike 3, and the inning is over. Now to the plate, here is Freudis Nova, and he'll get us started in what's officially the back third of this one. Right there at the belt, 1-2
now. 1 ball, 2 strikes.
fouls this one off. Ball and two strikes. Here it is. It's a wave and a miss. He struck him out. Next up is Robel Garcia. Third trip to the plate for him here tonight. 0-for-2 at this point. Even at a ball and a strike. Here's the pitch. And here's a pitch swung on and missed. 1-2 now. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt. And it's back to even at 2-2. And he goes against the shift there as this is on the ground at the left side. Throw on to first will get him. Score at 5-3 on the putout, though it looked more like a 6-3 ground ball. Nevertheless, there are two away now. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Hit down the line at first. This will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. Here comes the 1-2.
That's a ball.
Bases are empty here with two men
out.
Two
balls, two strikes.
Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And next to hit is the catcher, Chad Wallach. Inside for a ball as he falls behind to him here, 3-1.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
And he lays off, ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here. So the lineup flips over and digging in, Dexter Fowler. It was a walk in his last trip. A swing and a miss on a ball way out of the zone, and there's one away. So a runner at first now with one away. And sizing up the situation to bat will be Joe Adell. Now the 2-1 pitch. Into center field, line drive, base hit. To the plate now, Mike Trout. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
Off the plate that time and a little high. It's even at 2-2. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away. So here's the cleanup hitter, Anthony Rendon. No hits to this point. The set and the 3-1 pitch. Hit in the air down the right field line. Right fielder giving chase. And he brings it down to end the inning as the go-ahead run is left stranded. Ready to begin the eighth, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Ross Adolph. Here's the 1-1. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Two and two the count. Line hard toward right center, and this is going to get down for what should be extra bases, and there's your potential go-ahead run, and your go-ahead run is in at second base here with a leadoff double.
Now back, left fielder, Michael Brantley.
Into the box now, Michael Brantley. Here's a weakly hit fly ball off to the left side. And this is going to work out for him. It's a base hit. And the go-ahead run will move up to third and wisely hold there with nobody out. Standing in now, Ronnie Dawson. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Again, he sends it out of play. Runners are at first and third with none out. Popped him up. Rendon has room in foul territory. He's got it one away. Now at the plate is Taylor Jones. And their runners at the corners now.
Taylor Jones.
1-1. High in the air down the right field line. Fowler on the run. He makes the catch. Here comes the runner from third. Can't make the tag on him. He's safe. And they've taken the lead here in the eighth. Now into the box, number 13. Perhaps he can drive another one out of the park just like he did back in the second. Fly ball into straightaway left. Adele will get there and he puts it away to retire the side. Enoli Paredes is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. And now in the box, Matt Theis. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Down by one, I'm interested to see how they approach this as an offense, especially if they get someone on base early in the inning. Some teams, you know, they're going to try and manufacture that run, just trying to get that one run across. Others, they're going to look for one or two big swings to make it happen.
Got him.
The batter, number 44, designated hitter, Scott Kepler.
And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. All even now, 2-2. Swinging a ball hit on the ground.
After fouling off the second one, I got to step out of the box, adjust my batting gloves, and tell myself there's no chance he's tripling up on that pitch.
Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. Fouled off. Full count. 3-2.
These last two guys are making him work quite a bit out there. Both have been long at bats, and all in all, he's had to make 13 throws just to them so far.
Dawson will range to his left and put it away. Two down. So now here is Franklin Barreto. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Now the 2-1 is taken for strike two. Had the weight back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. Popped him up. Stubbs shading to his right, and he makes the catch to retire the side. James Hoyt enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. All set to start the ninth in this one, and standing in is the DH, Jordan Brewer. The 1-1 is a slider taken for a ball. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. Ready with the 2-2.
We got full count.
Pretty easy pitch to lay off there, 2-2. Not even close to being in the strike zone. He made it easy for the hitter in that one.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Trout has a read on it, looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. So now into the box is Freudis Nova. He went down on strikes last time up. Now the 3-2 pitch. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Digging in, the switch hitter, Robel Garcia. He grounded out last time up.
Garcia.
ready with the 1-1 pitch.
Ball, that's out.
Hits this one hard the other way, but the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit. And he will pull into second with a two-out double.
The batter, the catcher, Garrett Stubbs.
So now to the plate, Garrett Stubbs. This is hit the other way out toward left field. And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. Andre Scrub takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door.
Number 70, Andre.
All set for the bottom of the ninth, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Mitch Nay. Grounded softly down the line toward first, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. And another foul ball. Another 1-2 delivery. Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away.
Catcher.
So the next to bat will be Chad Waller. A hit and two tries for him so far. Here comes the 1-2. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Long run for the center fielder, but he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass. At the plate now, Dexter Fowler fouled away. And he fouls this one off. Down the first baseline. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Working for the punch out and the offering. And this runs inside, and that looked like it got him pretty good. Striding in is Joe Adell. The base knocked to the outfield could score the tying run from second. And it's fouled away. Back up the middle. The second for one. Back to first. A double play. And with that, the ball game is over.
Well, they sure made it interesting in the ninth, but they leave the tying run stranded at second and the winning run helplessly at first. Could have gone either way, but we were treated to a great battle.
3-2, the finish in tonight's game. Sugarland came through late, taking the lead in the eighth to secure the victory. Peter Solomon is credited with the win. So that'll put a wrap on things here this evening. For my partners Dan Plesac and Mark DeRosa, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a special presentation of MLB The Show. For more, follow us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Our final line score. First for the victorious Skeeters, 3 runs on 7 hits. No errors. They left 6 men on base. For the Bees, 2 runs, 6 hits. No errors. They left 10 men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 56 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.